Whether you are color grading Canon log footage, Sony S-log footage, D-log footage from your drone, or anything that gives you flat color profiles in your camera, in this video, I'm going to walk you through four simple steps, no matter what camera you're using, to get that perfect cinematic look and utilize all of the dynamic range that your camera has to offer. We're gonna cover how to get perfect contrast, saturation, manipulate any colors if you need to in your footage, and how to use finishing LUTs to make sure all of your footage looks linear in color. I've also prepared a sunny scenario, a cloudy scenario, and some footage with people in it, so that if you have to edit with people, we can also cover what that looks like. Now, I'm a Final Cut Pro user, and I will be using all of the tools that are built into Final Cut Pro, so you don't need any additional software to make these edits possible. Additionally, the tools that I'll be using are also available in Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve. We'll be using Waveforms and Vectorscopes to make sure that we are aligning all of our footage to what is called broadcast safe. And that way, no matter what monitor you're using, you can make sure that your footage will look good on any TV or wherever it might be displayed. Now that you guys know what you're getting into, let's hop into the computer and I'll show you guys how I edit this footage. All right, so for step one, we are talking about waveforms and how to utilize our highlights, shadows, and midtones to use the full dynamic range of our log footage. Now you can see in this particular clip, we have quite a bit of information here. Everything is in there. We've got all of our highlights, all of our shadows, and this was a really bright sunny day. And if you're curious on how to capture this footage and where the highlights should sit in your waveforms when you're capturing this, I highly recommend when you're shooting live to have your waveforms up so you can see where your highlights are landing and make sure to save those highlights in your footage. You never want to be overexposing your footage to make it look cinematic. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to add a color wheel. Now I have that kind of quick set to hit Control C to bring up my color wheels. I use this on every single clip, so I make sure to have quick functions. Now I'm going to come over here to my highlights and we're going to drag that all the way up to 100 IRE or just below it. So we've got a nice bright image. Now the brightest part of this image is there's two things. There's these kind of flashy things here and then the road. So we want to make sure that our highlights and our road match kind of what our eyes would naturally see on that day. So we're gonna land around kind of this, I don't know, I guess 80 IRE. The next thing we're gonna do is take our shadows and we wanna drag those down towards zero. Anything below zero means your shadows are gonna be crushed. Anything above 100 means your highlights are going to be crushed, and that means that they're gone. You can't see any more information in that space. I tend to go all the way to zero or close to, and all the way to 100, or depending on the scene, you maybe don't need to go all the way up to 100. So then from here, we're down to our lowest shadows and we've got our highlights set where we want. And now we're gonna use our midtones to kind of decide if we wanna brighten that up or if we wanna lower the contrast here. Now, because of step two, where we're gonna go into the curves, it's gonna actually help brighten the image. So I think the contrast here sits pretty nicely. I might brighten it just a little bit to get a bit more detail kind of in these shadow areas. So I like that, and then I'm gonna add a little bit of saturation. Of course, depending on your log footage, some of the saturation may be easier to put in or not. I'm using Canon C-Log footage and it tends to not need too much saturation and color grades really easily. So what you can see here is Final Cut actually builds in broadcast safe. And if you wanted to, you could drag that on your clip and then it's gonna crush, you can see here, it's gonna crush those highlights to make sure that it doesn't go above 100 and not below zero. So if we brought this down, you can see it's never gonna go below zero. It's gonna keep that broadcast safe. But we're not actually gonna use that and we're going to just make sure that we edit our footage properly. Now lastly, before we go into our curves tool, you can see in our Vectorscope on the left side here, it's showing kind of where our colors lie. Now if you go up past, you're gonna see that you're gonna crush some of those colors and you don't really wanna crush those colors. I wanna keep them kind of within this circle range here because otherwise it's getting really, really punchy. Okay, so moving into step two, we are looking at what are called curves. So the curves tool is how you get that cinematic kind of S curve, which so many of you have probably already heard of. This is not a crazy new thing. But one thing I love about the curves tool is that you can still maintain a really bright image while not crushing any of your highlights. So what I mean by that is we can make a pin up at the top here and we can start pushing our footage up higher to make sure it's bright while still coming down to the bottom here and maintaining a nice contrast point without, as you can see down here, we're not actually crushing any of our shadows. They're still maintaining in broadcast safe. So at this point, it becomes a creative decision how you want to add contrast to your footage. And again, if you're in Premiere Pro, and I don't know about DaVinci, but you might even just have a contrast slider, but you can see how this waveform will just separate but maintain highlights and lowlights, but that way you're kind of just dividing the contrast points between your highs and your lows. Now, one thing I particularly like to do is grab my midtones as well and kind of push those up, and you can see how it creates a really nice separation and kind of helps make cars or your subject kind of pop out of the frame. From here, depending on how much I've pushed that around, it is good to go back and just double check your saturation and make sure that that's kind of where you want it to be as well. Now in this image, the C-Log footage coming out of the Canon does manipulate some of the reds to turn into a purple hue. So I want to bring those purple hues back to a red hue. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a hue and saturation layer. I'm going to take my hue versus hue, and I know it's purple, but I'm just going to drag it over into some of these shadowy areas where I see that it's actually purple. And I'm going to start manipulating this to try and bring it back to the red side. Now you can see over in the Vectorscope over here that it's manipulating those purples and bringing them back to red. So I'm just gonna kind of play around with that until I have a very happy kind of red Ferrari again. So a lot of this stuff, you can just do very, very minor adjustments, but it's gonna make that car bring it back to the red that it's supposed to be instead of it being that purple look in the shadows. So there you go. As we play through the footage, we wanna make sure that none of the highlights or shadows are going too high. So here, I'm seeing that the road is a bit too high, so I'm actually gonna drag my highlights back down and maybe even my midtones to make it look like a bit more contrasty in that part, and then see if it looks good all the way through the scene. Now, before we move on to step four, I'm gonna color grade a couple of different scenarios. Here we have a bright background and a darker kind of foreground with our subject in it. So we're again gonna add our highlights, drag our highlights all the way up to 100, because that bright sunny sky, that sun is going to be at 100 IRE. We're then gonna drag our shadows down to a desired point, which I think about there is good. And we're actually gonna drag our shadows up because we want to bring back some of the detail here. Now you can see when I bring my midtones up, I need to bring my shadows back down to black there. And then here we're just gonna manipulate our saturation until it looks kind of natural to the eye. So I'm starting to see a lot of blues here and purples that I might wanna go into the color panels later and take care of. But for now, we're just gonna soften some of the highlights up here, make sure that none of those are being crushed. In the rims and on the hips of the car, we wanna make sure that those are really standing out. And then we're gonna come down here and bring back some contrast into the car and into those shadowy areas. And then there, you can really see what the mid-tone pop is doing there to bring out kind of the shapes of the car. So specifically in automotive stuff, this really, really helps. So the blacks are looking a little bit black to me, so I'm gonna come back and just drag that up so that we're making sure not to crush anything down here. And then we're gonna open up the hue, saturation, and curves panel. I'm just gonna come in here, click on the blues, and just desaturate those a little bit. There we go. Then we're gonna play through the clip and make sure that none of our blacks, highlights, or anything is being overexposed or crushed. This clip should be a little bit easier. It's mostly overcast, so we're just gonna bring our highlights up, not all the way, because in an overcast scenario, it's actually not gonna be at 100 IRE. It's gonna be around more the 75, 80 IRE. Then we get to choose our black points, bring that down, and then from here, we get to pick, do we want a brighter image or a more contrasty image? Now, I think I'm gonna try and bring a bit more detail out of the wheels by just bringing my midtones up a little bit. And then when we go into the curves panel, I'll bring the contrast back down. Just add a bit of saturation here. Add a curves layer. We're gonna make those highlights pop a bit, make sure those midtones are popping, and then bring down our contrast. And I'm kind of looking into these deeper areas to make sure that that contrast looks good. And this you can dial in to taste. There's a before and after of what the curves are doing. I think I'll bring these back up a little bit. It's looking a little too contrasty for me, but that's what the color curves are doing there. Now here we've got a DJI clip, and I've always found DJI needs a little bit of a different treatment with their log footage. First and foremost, of course, we're going to make sure that our highs and lows and mids are exactly where we want them to be. And I find that the mid-tones generally don't need too much manipulation, but what I do find that drone footage needs a lot of is saturation. So you can see we've got our highs, our lows, and our mids are sitting pretty good, but we need to push that saturation for this footage to really come alive again. And I think we're gonna need to bring our mid-tones down. Now it's starting to look really dark, but where we're gonna bring that back is in the curves. So we're gonna add that curve. And up in the sky here, I wanna make sure that we maintain these highlights because they're pretty close to crushed. So I'm just gonna drag that down a little bit to make sure we're not blowing out the sky. Then I wanna kinda get this track looking good again. So maybe in our mid-tones, we can bring that up. And then we're gonna add that contrast back in here. We wanna make sure it's still looking really bright so you can see the mid-tones are really starting to pop that track out. We've saved the sky, which is exactly what we want, and we're able to make that track pop. So this is what the curves is doing. That is really making that footage come back to life. Now I'm gonna go back into my color wheels and make sure that everything's saturated and looking just how it should. I don't feel like I need to manipulate any of the colors in this image, so we're just going to move on to what it might look like to manipulate some footage with a person in it. So it's the same process here. We're gonna add colors. We're gonna make sure our highlights are where we want them to be. We're gonna make sure that our shadows are where we want them to be down here as well. This was a bright, sunny, hot day. And from here, we're gonna either add exposure, which I think I want to do because as you can see, my face is covered by the hat. So if I brought the contrast down too much, we're losing a lot of that detail. So I'm gonna bring the mid-tones up, bring our blacks back where we want them, add a touch of saturation. And again, you can kind of see here, the reds are turning really pink. So we're gonna go in and fix that in a little bit. Go into our color curves. And we're gonna start to add some pop and life and bring our contrast back so it looks more realistic. Now this is great, again, because we're not crushing any of our blacks. None of the details are going away and we're still getting back a nice contrasty image. So from here, I'm gonna go in and fix, I'm just gonna grab this hue versus hue, grab this pink look and bring it back up to what the natural red looking color is. And it doesn't take a big change, just a little bit, and it makes a huge difference. Now the last step in this process is one of my favorites where you get to use finishing LUTs. Now these are just LUTs that give you a look over your entire footage. Now I have mine set to option E and I'm going to go up here and add a finishing LUT. Now I'm working on my own pack so you guys can stay tuned because I'm starting to create some really cool finishing LUTs for your footage that can go over top of everything. Now, they're not LUTs to bring contrast back, they're just LUTs to add a final look. I'm super excited about releasing these LUTs. I'm gonna be swapping out my whole entire store and I'm really excited to show you guys this stuff. Now, ultimately guys, I do hope that this has educated you guys on how to take your log footage and make it look contrasty and beautiful and cinematic again. But I do hope that you have found this helpful. If you did guys, smash that like button. And if you want more content like this, be sure to subscribe to the channel and I'll be doing more tutorials like this in the future for you. Other than that guys, I really do appreciate your time and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace.